I'm kind of fucking pissed right now. Because apparently, I was recording to my SD card and not my phone. So I was limited by 4 gigabytes, which is the total amount of the SD drive, not even the entire thing. So I obviously have some pictures on there, so I was limited incredibly. But I have something to show you guys before I show you the tech tour. I call it a life tour, not a house tour, a life tour. As you can see, I'm not fat. What a mystical surprise. Whoa, look at this scale. The fan's on because I just took a shower. 136.8. I'm actually kind of underweight, but that should not... Oh, look, a mirror. Oh, no, you won't get to see my face. This is my room. I like to keep it dark, tidy, and... Well, that's it. Over here we have my VR set right there, my speaker. What is that? Oh, that's my airsoft gun. My charge pack, my wireless charger, my iPad, my heated blanket right there. It's underneath this. And here's my other airsoft gun. And, oh, he's so fucking cool because he's got airsoft guns, dude. Legendary, dude. Fucking legendary, dude. But here's, you can't, with that, see? There's me. I'm not fat. What a surprise. It's cold out here in the wastelands of Minnesota, but we get by. We get by. I am a supporter of InfoWars, as some of you may know. I don't think I've actually ever announced that, but here's the supplements I take if you guys watch InfoWars. If you don't, check it out, InfoWars.com. Biome Defense Probiotic, because I don't poop enough. And Survival Shield X2, this thing will work wonders for you, only 20 bucks. Get it now. And I have Brain Force from my father, because he works 12 hours a day. And he used to take 5-hour energy. And that stuff ruins your kidneys. Used to have a PS3 connected to that TV, 56-inch TV. Now I don't. This is the dungeon, okay? That's at least what my parents call it. None of this is mine. It's all my mother's. Please ignore it. That TV used to be cool in 2003. And as you can see, Hillary from prison 2016. Now this kind of has a nice story right here. This is my noob trap, as you can see. It is fishing line and a paperclip as a fishing lure and a gummy worm on it that's as hard as a rock. Don't eat it. It doesn't even bend anymore, with Swedish fish attached to it. Basically, what you need is a stable security defense system. And if you're a noob, you're just going to be like, oh, fucking up, Riley Deed, and you're going to fucking hit it. And it's going to hurt a lot. So it has hurt people in the past, and it's good because that way I know they're a noob, and I won't let them into the premises. So, Hillary from Prison 2016, InfoWars, go check it out. Here's the beautiful, look at that, you see that? I'll show you that later. Here's the beautiful, I used to sit on this chair. As you can see, it has no padding at all. It would hurt me. It did bad things to me. This isn't mine, except for this. This is part of the chair. Right back there, I have the arm rests. I took them off because I can't fit into the desk with them on. Not because I'm fat. I just showed you that. That's a monitor that I used to use. It's for a shitty old 2003 PC. There's two 2003 PCs in here in this box. I can't get it open because it's underneath the counter. Two 2003 PCs in there, and a few boxes of my crap. There's the box for my motherboard. I put random manuals and stuff in there. And parts. like little screws and stuff and zip ties. Here's my 750. I used to have the 750 Ti before I put the 970 in there. But this is the 970 box. As you can see, GeForce GTX 970. It's refurbished. I got it for $180. Get your shit refurbished if you can. There it is right there, the GeForce GTX 750 Ti superclocked. I'm trying to sell it to someone. Not online though, because that shit's unreliable. But I don't know how much I got that for. I can't remember. This this stuff and the stuff that's in the computer, that totals up to about $1,500. So I know a guy who has a $7,000 computer, but he has like four 1080s, and it's very unnecessary. This is a German microphone company, Aukey. Go check them out. The microphone I use is over there. I'll show you that in a minute. But I put the pop filter in there, as you can see, with my janky ass spelling. In there is the power supply box, also refurbished. Oh, wait, no, that's not refurbished, but I got for like $60 because it was on sale. I needed a better power supply when I got my new graphics card. But the guy at Micro Center, which you guys should go to if you buy expensive shit, he said we have the top of the line for sale for like $60. And I said, sure. So in here, I put the old power supply. I won't open it up. 450 power supply, also Corsair. And fan and eight hard drive power cables for the motherboard and the power supply. This is my PC case box with the styrofoam in it. The reason why I do that is if I ever have to move my PC, I'll just plop it in there and go. In there I have a surge protector, which I can't actually use because my PC won't boot up if I plug it in. It'll literally shut down because it leeches so much power. There is a... What is this? Oh, this is a microphone cable that I accidentally bought. But they refunded it without me having to send it back. That's pretty fucking cool. That's a speaker system that my brother gave me. Show you that, guys, in a second. There's my Ultra HD monitor, 4K monitor, which I'll show you guys in a second. If you're subscribers of this channel, you know what it is. Got myself that as a Black Friday gift. Also kept the box, because if I need to move it, this is another precious, expensive part of my computer, and it will protect it. That's what you guys should do. If you have expensive parts of your PC that you need to keep protected when you move it, keep the boxes. So what I'll basically do whenever I have to move my computer, which will likely be in the spring, next spring, when I go to college, I think that's when I'm going to go to university. Just to let you guys in on a secret, Winona State University up here in Minnesota. Look at that. There's the weekend poster that my friend got me. I was in a college prep program as a high schooler, and they taught me a lot of stuff. What we also did is tour so many colleges, and they all had, they're so fucking basic. So basic. And they were all the same. The only thing that was different was the tuition a little bit. We saw colleges anywhere from $7,000 a year in tuition to $45,000 or $60,000 in tuition. And we were all like, fuck no. Don't do that, people. No matter how good the college is and how good they will swoon you in, don't fucking give them that much money.
Okay, I got distracted, but the point of the story is, I had to, and one other friend of mine, were basically the only not goody-goodies of the entire class, and we had to come up with a rating system that differed these, and we noticed that there is a lot of attractive women at college. This was obvious, but we had to come up with a rating system of just how attractive these women were, and their comparison to the ones that weren't so fucking attractive. And so I came up with a rating system. It's called hot girl to girl ratio, okay? The amount of attractive women compared to the amount of normal women. And that college, Winona State University, has an unbeatable ratio of 1 to 1. There was one hot girl for every normal girl. And just make sure you know, not ugly, just normal. It also includes ugly women, though. But we walked through the gym, and there's ellipticals on each side of us facing away. And I nearly suffocated. That's all I'll say.
Don't. The rest of this shit is my mother's. She can't handle her shit. There's a picture of me and my old Boy Scout, or my Cub Scout pack. No, a den is what they called it. I won't show you a close-up because that would be face reveal. It's my trash can and my bag where I put my aluminum cans. You're like, oh, you're fucking fat as shit, dude. Like, what the fuck? Like, no, it takes me months to fill that up. I have like one or two or three pops a week. I have a mini fridge back from my father's real estate days. It's just for convenience. I don't even use it that much. But I keep Diet Mountain Dew. That's just for people who when they come over. Emergency water bottles. I forgot about this. So, this is Sierra Mist Cranberry Splash. What makes this so special is they don't sell it anymore. And it tastes so fucking good. Oh, it tastes so good. So it says Red's Elixir Potion on it. I forgot that I put that on there. That's fan-fucking-tastic. That's just for people when they come over. They're supposed to be Diet Dr. Pepper and Diet Mountain Dew. Like, people are like, well, you on a fucking diet? No, I'm skinny enough as it is. I just think Diet Mountain Dew tastes better than regular Mountain Dew. People are like, what the fuck is your problem, dude? Like, that, I just think. Same with Diet Dr. Pepper. I just think Diet Dr. Pepper tastes better than the regular Dr. Pepper. Here's a fun story, though. I was once at a friend's house, and he had his, like, douche friend over. And I was about to crack open a Diet Mountain Dew. And you guys probably know this about Pepsi and all this shit. But when in the 80s, when they were making diet pops, Pepsi got the genius idea of putting this chemical called aspartame in it. And they're like, yeah, this will give you, like, the diet thing you're needing while still making it not taste like shit. So the executives were like, okay, fucking do it, dude. And they were... Apparently, it causes cancer, or it can cause cancer. This dude snatches it out of my hand, and he's like, he looks at the ingredients really intently, like fucking, like, and he's like, he puts it back in my hand, and he's like, don't drink this. And I say, okay, I'll bite. Why? And he's like, because it's got aspartame in it. And I didn't know what it was at the time. And I was like, okay, what's fucking aspartame? And he's like, it can give you cancer. And I'm like, if I fucking get cancer after drinking this, and I don't fucking, even if I don't die, you can have all of my stuff. Every fucking last bit. And all of my money. Because I probably have to drink 1,000 of those to even get a chance of getting fucking cancer. 1,000 in a fucking day! I would die before I did that. I would die of just fucking unhealthiness before I did that. So here's the actual spec tour. There's the 4K monitor. That was my first monitor. Got it off of a friend for $50. Got that off of a pawn shop for $30. I don't know how, but it's still fucking dirty. Like, dirty. I took fucking electronic wipes like 50 times to it, and it's still like fucking dirty. It's like someone, like a makeuped woman, just like fucking just splashed her face on there and like rolled her face. Because it was like the electronic wipe was like brown. Like foundation brown of just woman makeup. That's a Red Dragon mouse. My brother got it for me last Christmas, or for my birthday. He also got this for my birthday, Steelseries. I'm actually thinking of upgrading to a computer pad. If you guys don't know what that is, it basically lays across your desk and you put your keyboard on it and you put your mouse on it. And your mouse has like so much more freedom. It does have a lot of freedom with the Steelseries thing, but it gets so much more. There's my controller that I just got. Here's Satan 3000 right here. Business statistics, don't even get me started. Windows 98. No, we don't fucking use it anymore. Windows 2003. Windows 98, Windows 2003. Fucking fantastic. Those two computers in there are Windows 2003s. No, we don't use it anymore. So Logitech G105, I got this when I first got my computer. Did it? What the fuck? Did you hear that? It's fine. This is connected through DisplayPort. That's a familiar sight to you guys, if you know what I am. VGA to HDMI, I connected it through. VGA. So this is the power supply I was talking to you about, AX650. I think it's one of the top of the line. When it's at low power states, the fan isn't on. So the fan is not on right now. That small buzz you hear is from this fan, which I recently installed. It came with the computer, but I took it out temporarily just because I didn't need it. If anyone tells you that you need a better CPU fan, they're fucking lying. As long as you have heatsink, which comes with the processor, and the fan properly tuned, usually on standard, it's fucking fine. What you have to worry about is the heat coming off of your graphics card, because you cannot customize the fan usage unless you have like a 1080, 3000, fucking 3000, custom model, that bullshit. So, as you can see, my CPU's, when running nothing, is 100. And they get, this is PC Meter. Get PC Meter. All these gadgets are made by PC Meter. Network meter, GPU meter, and CPU usage. You can measure the temperature of each and every single core of your CPU. Hawking fantastic, dude. There's a self-portrait I made of myself 2 years ago in art class. I made with chalk pastels. The real thing is in my room. This is a picture of it. That's actually what I look like. Besides the skeptical look. I'm not Asian. I'm not fucking Asian. Okay? And ignore the skeletal look of my fucking esophagus and windpipe. But that's actually what I look like in the picture. So, this is a Raid Max case. I got it for like $40. Totally worth it. Except for the fact that the headphone jacks don't work on the front. Don't know why. I've checked the cables. They were janky to begin with, so. But it's not that big of a problem. Only the left ear works. So that's a Geforce GTX 970. I got it for $180 refurbished. There is the fan that came with the case right there. This is a fan I recently got just to make it look cool. However, it's the noisiest thing on the fucking computer. And if I keep the display port connected, it will stay on and lit. It's creepy as fuck when it's off. When the computer is off, it's so fucking creepy. So I have to disconnect the display p- port for the 4K monitor. Every time I turned it off, and I have to keep it unplugged when I boot it up, or else the computer won't boot up. Don't ask me. I've tried everything. It goes like, like it starts up and then it goes down, and it's, oh, just what the fuck? It's so annoying. I've tried everything. I've tried restoring my computer. I know a lot of things about computers, and doesn't do anything. Here's my chair. I bought it for $180.
No, it's not fucking the racer, dude. It's not a fucking like DX fucking racer, dude.
It's not, okay? Because I would have to pay $300 more for literally the same fucking thing. As you can see, the only difference is don't say like fucking DX racer, dude. Fucking DX racer, your ass. DX racer, fucking. 3,000, dude, and it reclines right here. I won't pull it because it's like fucking bolt. Like, it'll just fucking spray. It's like, and you have to like lay up against it with the perfect amount of pressure and then pull it. Okay? But it is Gigantex. So I hope this works when I upload it to Google Drive. It was taking so long and I got so fed up. It's because it was in the SD drive, not my phone. So now hopefully that's fixed. That's just a laptop. It works perfectly fine using Windows 7. I just don't use it that much. I don't know why no one in my house uses it. But so I have a solid state drive, Samsung Evo. 256 gigabytes. I have the operating system on that, so it boots up very, very quickly. Sometimes I put games on there. I put Ark on there because I used to play it a lot. Now I don't. Everyone's so occupied with shit. There's my first hard drive, 1 terabyte Western Digital. Get Western Digital. Fantastic hard drives for a very low price. Here's my second hard drive that I got in like fucking December or November. Another 1 terabyte, except it's hard drive V, so I just put my videos and all of my pirated games. I have a pirated game video. Fantastic way to save a lot of money. Don't judge me. But those are all my pirated games. These are about $400 worth of games. And that's just the blockbusters. GTA 5, Fallout 4, Doom, Mafia 3. All the blockbusters just gets me up to 400, okay? So that's fantastic. In there I have an i5-4690K. I think that's the best i5. There I have a HyperX 8GB RAM, DDR3. And right next to it, I have a Crucial 4GB RAM. I really want to upgrade to 16GB and get another... Or wait a second. That's HyperX Fury. I think I have a Crucial in there. What? I thought I was going to get a Kingston. No. I got a Crucial 4GB dual set when I first got my computer, and I realized that was a fucking mistake. Now I have 12 gigs of RAM, Hyper with 8, and Crucial with 4. I have the other Crucial stick lying somewhere over there. And, I don't know what fan company that is. A janky one for like $12. Don't get one of those fucking fans. It looks cool, but it's like, I don't care much about noise, but this is fucking noisy. Like, I don't care at all. It's like, I don't know why people do. Like, you're gonna be wearing fucking headphones the whole time. Kotion Each G2000. My brother got it for me for my Christmas last year. Here's the controller that I just got. Matricom. I like it because it's set up like a PS3. But it also has the triggers on it. But the buttons are set up like Xbox, so that's fantastic. I like that a lot. Here's my Ratchet and Clank collection for PS3. I like Ratchet and Clank, but I don't have one. I want a PS3, and I want to put it right fucking there. That would be awesome. But used ones, go for $100. I know you're saying, dude, you have a $1,500 computer. Why would you not spend $100 on a PS3? Because my brother fucking has one, and he doesn't use it anymore. I'm trying to swoon him into giving it back to me. So, there's a subwoofer right there. My brother gave me this set because he said the speakers were broken. That right there, that cable right there, goes to and connects up to that subwoofer system. There I have a speaker, and there I have a speaker. This one doesn't work. Whenever friends come over, however, I plug in that cable right there into the subwoofer. I have a clever deal going back here. I have an audio splitter in the headphone cable back there, or in the headphone jack back there, and part of it is going to this headset. And that it lights up, by the way. If you can't see that, you can't really see that. You can see it over here. Used to use that mic, but I would put it on my, I would like take it off and put it over my shoulders. And surprisingly enough, it hurts my collarbones. Don't be like, oh, you're fucking weak, dude. Like, you can't fucking take, you do it. You put your fucking headphones on your collarbones for fucking 3 hours. It starts to fucking hurt. If you don't have fucking meat on your bones like I don't. So, I have a headphone splitter jack back there. And it's part of it's going to the subwoofer. And part of it is going to my headphones. So, I get to, when I'm playing action intense games, I get to hear it very well on the headphones. And feel it very well on the subwoofer. It's quite fantastic. So here's my microphone that you hear my beautiful voice through all of the time. It's an Aukey something. I have it off to the side when I'm not recording. It's gold, right? It's not. What I basically do is I pull it forward, and then I speak into it like that. This cable is about 15 feet long. I had to buy it. It goes all the way down, around, and to the computer. I know, I'm sorry. Once you get a PC, you realize that you need a lot more than what you currently have. And that's what happened to me. I had to replace my processor. I was running a Pentium. A really good Pentium, though. A really good Pentium. G2000 something? I don't know. But now I'm running a better one. Same with my graphics card. Same with the power supply. And same with the RAM. Don't fuck up, kids. You need a good PC. If you want a good PC, you need to spend at least $1,000. Assuming you have the basic shit. A computer, or a keyboard, a mouse, and a monitor. Yes, I have 3 displays. Pretty fantastic. What else? What else am I forgetting? Solid state, I have an ASUS 20 buck freaking disk drive. Disk drives are pretty outdated. No one buys PCs on disk anymore. Not really at all. That one's connected through HDMI. I think I already said that. I did. Motherboard, I have an ASUS Z97i Plus. Always get an ASUS motherboard. Those things are king. As you can see, 5x protection, 7,000 hours, and 1,000 compatible devices. Get an ASUS motherboard, I swear to God. I have a mini ITX, not the full ATX. That's where the motherboard ends, right fucking there. It's super small. It's very small. One clever thing is, I used to run this thing off of Wi-Fi through the ASUS motherboard. As you can see, that little box right there with the numbers on it, that has two little things coming off of it. Two little spiker thingies. I have to wire them carefully around the graphics card back over here. You can't see anything. But basically, it comes to an antenna right there. This is on the back of the computer. I used to wire that shit
up and around, and I used to have a little, it's magnetic. I used to have a little metal thing right here that I would put it on, and the router is like beyond that room. In that room, there's a furnace, and it's like fucking, it's up, it's away, it's a, so far away. I would need like a 50-foot Ethernet cable if I wanted to directly connect it. I didn't know they have these things, but they do. I was actually looking for an Ethernet cable on Amazon, and I found this cool system. So, as you can see right there is an Ethernet cable thing. Well, if you don't fucking have a 50-footer, what did you do? They have these things. They have these cool things. It's a, what is it? It's a TP-Link Nano 500. It can handle up to 500 gigabytes per second. As you can see, that Ethernet cable was running to that little plugger-inner thingy. And apparently, they use the technology from the wiring in your house, furnace room, and they basically create a virtual Ethernet cable connection through the lines in your house. So this is my family's computer, basically when my father uses it, and there is the shitty computer. But here's the router right here. There it is, the same Ethernet cable. Oh, fucking mystical, dude. But no, there it is right here. The same, when you buy it, it costs like, $30. They also have a 1,000 gigabyte thing and a 250 gigabyte per second thing. I think actually this is the 250. So basically it's a virtual Ethernet connection. Not as good as an Ethernet connection. Look it up though, TP-Link. $30 for 250 gigabyte per second. And you connect it to anything in the house. You can't connect it to a power strip because it doesn't work at all when you do that. And you connect it and you plug it in, and then you just plug it in wherever your router is. And boom, it's a virtual Ethernet connection. Not as good as the real thing, but a fuck ton better than Wi-Fi. That's for damn sure. And so my speed increased by 2 megabytes per second download. It used to be like 5. Now it's like 7.5 at peak speeds. It's pretty awesome. If you guys have any questions, please leave a comment. I made this because someone requested it. I was actually kind of thinking of it. I just didn't know how I was going to film it. And then I realized my phone has a really good camera. So I did it through my phone. I put my water bottle right here with a cooler on it. You put your phone in here and it's a phone stand. It's pretty neat. I put my thumbnails on the screen saver. Yep, I just came in my pants, guys, and while I was recording this video. I know this was kind of long. There's going to be minimal editing in this. But if you have any questions, please leave a comment. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you do, subscribe.